You are watching UNICEF television. At the Free Children from War conference in Paris, France, former child soldier Ishmael Beah urged attendees to fund rehabilitation programs.
And I didn't have a choice, because at that time I had lost all my family, and my mother, father, and two brothers were killed in the war by the RUF. And as a result, I had been running around by myself with a bunch of friends, trying to run away from the war for almost a year, and then found myself in a village occupied by the Sierra Leone army. And it was basically a choiceless situation. It was either to stay there and be part of, be recruited into the army, or leave, which was as good as being dead. Because once you looked for shelter in one place and tried to escape, the other group would kill you. As a child soldier in one of these groups, it's not as you act in a regular army. There were no outlined missions of what you needed to do. Basically, the war in Sierra Leone, in my opinion, became a war of survival. So being part of a squad meant that you had to fight for your ammunition and for your food. And because of the continuous and rampant killing and violence, you've been traumatized in the use of drugs, from your common marijuana, cocaine, to brown, which is a combination of cocaine and gunpowder. You were traumatized, and so killing had become as easy as doing anything. It was a reality. So if the commander said, we're going to this village because those people sympathize with the rebels, or these villagers are the rebels, we're going to kill them so we can get supply of food and ammunition, you went and shot people and killed people and did whatever. So basically, day-to-day missions were that. Simply put, every day was full of violence and drug use. That was the life. During the war, all sides of the war were using children. And what happened was that UNICEF, Human Rights Watch, NGOs started creating programs to get children out, because there was a really rampant use of children. So I was fortunate enough to be one of those kids who was released. And this was in 1996 that I came to the rehabilitation center, where I underwent my rehabilitation and regained my life again. I feel that it is very important to talk about my experience, even though it's very difficult to do so all the time, because when I first came to the United States in 1998, I realized that there was very little known about what was going on in Sierra Leone, so I felt compelled to speak about it. But also I felt compelled to put a face to what has been happening to children, not just in Sierra Leone, but around the world. To show that it is possible, with the right support and help and right programs in place, that children can regain their lives again and be themselves again. And I think it's a very important work, and it needs to be done as the use of children continues as we speak.